Hello, hello, and welcome back to Modding Kits, episode 37. And, well, as the series has been continuing, and by series I mean the last two episodes, this episode will also be a bit more about Mekanism. That's right, I can't get enough of this. Like, there's a lot of things I can do with this mod, and I love it. So, also, by the way, yes, first things first, I got to know what this seismic vibrator thingy does, because apparently, there's another thing that we need to make for it, which requires another storage tablet or whatever the hell, but that's fine. But we make this perfect. And then I think you're supposed to place this in. Or maybe not. I think we need to give it power, which we are giving. Lovely. So let us get this have power, which is basically a portable machine that uses seismic vibrations to provide information on differing layers of the world. So I think this will now... Oh, right. I have to provide power to this. If I do this, there we go. And if I right click this, well, there we go. Achievement made. Just vibing. So you can see exactly what is there and where. So at 20, you can see there's a bit of air. Otherwise, there's this. But, well, that was the usage of it. If we use it up, we got to know what it is. Great. I'm never going to use it again. The next thing, and the first thing technically for the episode that we are going to be doing is... I was thinking of this HDPE enforced Elytra, to be fair. Like, what is it? Why is it? How does it work? What does it do? Like, does it... You know... You can use it to fly with energy or something? I don't know. Does it increase the durability? That's why, or something? I have zero clue. But it is what it is. Now, pressurized reaction chamber is what we would end up requiring for that. And that looks like a big fancy machine, which requires a lot of stuff. So let's make four dynamic tanks first. And then now first we need to do this, along with which we need to do what? Metallurgic infuser is still fine. We just need a bit of infused alloys and diamond dust. That should be easy. We take these. We have the diamonds. That is fine. The diamonds need to be crushed though. Oh wow. Clearly not receiving enough energy. Of course it isn't. Energy. Do all of this. That's the input. Perfection. And then inside the metallurgic thingy, which I would like to take one, which has its own power, that would be nice. Because we don't really need the rotary condensator, so yeah, we're gonna put that away as well. And we'll provide power to this one. Perfect. So that we can add in a bit of diamond and one of these. What? Is that not what it was? I don't get it. We need 20 diamonds. Okay, you need two of them. That's also fine. That is fine. We'll put in more. There you go. Perfect. We have a reinforced alloy. Yes, please. We have made it stronger. But we need to make it even more stronger with refined obsidian. And that also four of them. Wow. Okay. A bit, no, not here, actually. What? It is empty. Why is it not working? Oh, because it's obsidian dust. God damn it. I need the refined obsidian dust. And perfect. Now we crush this off. Get a few of these. Until then, I think we can make the other things. Or maybe not. HDPE pellets require the pressurized reaction chamber, which still requires two basic chemical tests. These thingies. So we can make those. And... Oh, and then we need an enrichment chamber as well. Okay, we'll have to make a few basic controls. Oh, wow. I think I might be out of osmium. Yep, we literally only have 10 osmium left. Ooh. Hey, that's a bit tough finish you. Pa-pa-pa-pa-pa. This one has carbon. Yes, dump it. Put that in. Put this in. We'll get a few of these, but that's definitely an issue. Perfect, that's 60, we'll need two more. Only need the two actually. And voila, perfect. So that should still have 40 left inside. There we go, the atomic top tier alloy. But anywho, we made an enrichment chamber. Or, yes, it's called chamber only. Please don't tell me I already had one. I should have checked better. Ugh. A bit stupid. Bit stupid, not gonna lie. Especially because I'm a little bit low on resources. Alas, such is life. What else can I say? Now, we have the enrichment chamber already. We just needed the pressurized reaction chamber. That, I'm sure, I don't have. For which we need an enrichment. Oh, saved. Haha, saved. Huh? See, that was calculated. I just was making fun. Haha, I totally, definitely knew that I had an enrichment chamber. And I did not make one by mistake at all. Absolutely not. Of course not. Why? No, not a chance in... Anyway, moving on. We'll make the pressurized reaction chamber thingy, for which we need an enrichment chamber, which we already have. Voila! Lovely! And then this is for what again? HDPE pellets, yes. For that we need liquid. Ooh, wow, okay. We can get the oxygen still, but how the hell do I get the liquid ethylene? Condensator thingy. For that we need ethylene. Now how do we get ethylene? From water and hydrogen and biofuel. Pressurized reaction chamber. Okay, so we gotta put in water, we gotta put in hydrogen. Water. How? I don't know. But it would be better. Why is it empty? What? I right-clicked into it. It's not empty, yeah. It has a bit of water in it. Yeah, that's what I thought. How do we use this again? It's literally nowhere does it say how to add water. What in the world? See, that's the problem. If you don't have a proper system, it's kinda hard sometimes. It's supposed to have water inside. I just don't know how to add water to it. Huh. Let me think about this for a second though. Okay, so I figured out one part of it. I got hydrogen inside from this by putting this here. Now for the water, however, how will I do this? It is hard to understand this thingy. Without any tutorials and stuff, obviously. I could just watch a tutorial and I would know everything there is to know about it. That wouldn't matter. But it's not fun that way. I kind of want to do my thingy my way, if you will. Why is this so hard to figure out? I don't understand. Items? No. Energy? No. Fluids? No. Gases? Yes. Now for the gases, it should output the gas. Auto-eject on. No, not input. Output it. Perfect. And it has energy, so it's not like it doesn't have energy to do that. Why is it not outputting this? Why can't I remove this? Will I have to give in and Google? Is that what it is all about? Let me think a bit more about this. It worked. It worked. Oh my word. It took forever. Oh, I had been roaming around doing so many things and it finally worked with something called a gauge dropper. Oh, look at the amount of stuff I've done. I made advanced mechanical pipes and I used these and oh my word. But we have some things now, so that is nice. Oh my word, it is annoying when things do not work out like this, especially if you have no way of knowing how it works. That's what makes it really annoying, because anywho, it works now. That's what matters. Do we have any water in this? Yes. So we right click this using the water and then it can basically drop items inside of it. That's it. Oh, it works. We have these substrate thingies basically. I think I can remove water from this. Yes, that's perfect. So we have removed the water. We have the first thing we needed to make. Oh my word, that worked. Oh, oof. Well, we need the substrate then to have some ethylene and oxygen in it. Now the oxygen I can still provide, The ethylene though, I don't know how in the world am I gonna make that. Using water and hydrogen, as it turns out. You can also get it. Oh, inside of this, when I did that, apparently I should have gotten... okay, that's cool then. If I right click here, do we get it? Yes, we do. Perfect. And then, what was the actual recipe for it? Oxygen and liquid ones. We need liquid. That is fine. We have a thing which makes those into liquid. If I can... This one, yes, perfect. I might have to make another gorge though, because okay, these are lifesavers, these gorge thingies. As it turns out, I just got to know I don't have the osmium ingot for it. Oh no. Well, I guess I'll have to quickly go and gather a few ores. I'll be right back after a few ores have been gathered. Alright, we are back with our osmium ingot. Don't worry, I didn't just get the one, I got more. It's getting smelted, don't worry, we have more. But we have to remove the hydrogen from here. Yes, we do have an extra empty tank, so might as well add it in here. There we go, perfect. So we have hydrogen in here as well, apparently. And now we have a bit of liquid oxygen inside here, which is also good. I don't think I can add the liquid oxygen in there, obviously. But we have the next thing needed for it, more or less. Except we gotta add in liquid ethylene and oxygen inside of it. So for the oxygen, I think we'll have to do a bit of electrolytic separator thingy. Yes, we have liquid oxygen, which we can convert into this. I don't know how it worked. I forget. No, it was a condensator thingy. Yes, that's the one that required it. Where did I put it then? That is not it. That is not it. That is the one. Yes. If I put the liquid oxygen in here, which I can't, decondensating, I guess. Perfect. We put that in. The liquid oxygen got used up. Oxygen is being made. Lovely, lovely, lovely. So we have oxygen as well now. That is brilliant. I could use, of course, let's take this, excellent, and now what is the recipe? I have to be perfectly correct about it. Yes, this one. So we need the oxygen over here. So that is the oxygen, perfect, and that is the ethylene. If I could put it in, I apparently cannot, damn it. Why do you do this? Oh, because it requires a liquid one, I assume. It requires a liquid form of it. Absolutely, it does. Okay, so we make it into this. We put the ethylene here, which then makes it liquid. Lovely. I need to provide this with a power source. Yes, yes, yes. I'm giving you power, my friend. Don't you worry. Lovely. Oh, things are working out finally. It took me so long. I was like, I will not Google it, no matter what. So I went through so many of these mechanism things and I was like, okay, I don't know if this would work, I don't know if this would work, I don't know if this would work. And then this one worked. Oh my word, that was... Oof. But yes, it has been quite a journey learning about these things, not gonna lie. Would not recommend, just Google it. This is a bit hard. It was fun, but this is just a bit too much, like, I don't know. Anywho, we don't need the electrolytic separator for now. I guess we could just add in... Actually, yeah, let's not do that. This is still fine. We have liquid. Yes, please. Let's take these. Let's put this in here. Perfect. Yes, yes, I know you require power as well. I'll provide that. Do not you worry. Voila! Should work now. And we have the HDPE pellets. Oh, lovely. Yes, so from the enrichment chamber. Yes, 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 perfect. So we have an enrichment chamber. There you go. We put that in. And that already is powered with the solar panels. So three of these can make one, if I'm not mistaken. Come on. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Yes, please. Perfect. Oh, and it ran out at the perfect time as well. Look at that. I just ran out of energy because I used it, I took the solar panel from here to put it inside here, so... But yes, perfection. We don't need that anymore because we have everything we need for an HDPE reinforced Elytra. What does that do? It basically just increases your durability is what it looks like. I don't know if you can, you know... Ah, you can enchant it. Okay, I guess let's go enchant it then. I think I can add the unbreaking. Oh, right. I should. Let's add the unbreaking 3. And I can add the mending in as well. Let me bring that. But basically, we have an much better Elytra now. Brilliant. Here is the mending. Here is our anvil. Excellent. Look at that. An Elytra with 648 durability instead of the 200 and something, which I'm sure, of course, now this can probably be used for other things as well, as we already saw. It can be used to make HDPE reinforced Elytra to the mecha suit. So basically, you can start, you know, making... I guess we can probably do a bit more of the mechanism, but this was annoying. I had fun, but to a certain point, it then becomes annoying because you don't really know what to do. Because there is no clear instructions, there's no manual, there's nothing. Which, yes, I know, that's how Minecraft works in most of the things, but it can get a bit frustrating. Because, well, yes, it's hard to understand all of these things. Minecraft's still a bit simpler. The modded stuff, I feel like it's there to make your life better, to make your life easier. Then just provide a better manual or a better way of, you know, a better... Anywho, the ranting aside, that was it. That was fun for this episode. We found it. We finally made the HDPE. I hope I'm saying this right. I hope it's HDPE and not hope, H-O-P-E, but with the O written as a D for some reason, God knows why. But yes, we made the HDPE reinforced Elytra as well. That was lovely. And yes, oh, I didn't see how it looks actually. Right, we have the cape. I might have to switch off the cape first. Where is that thing? Skin. Yes, and cape is off. Done. Ah, a white tool of Elytra. Interesting. That looks nice, actually. Not bad. But that's it for this episode. I hope you had fun. I shall see you in the next one. Like, share, subscribe, comment, yada yada yada. Bye-bye.